Senator, thanks for joining us. You just heard Rand Paul talking on why he opposes Mike Pompeo and Gina Haspel. What's your response?
I think he's an outlier, Senator Paul, certainly within the Republican Party. My response is that Mike Pompeo is a highly qualified person to be Secretary of State, number one in his class at West Point, Army officer, member of Congress, CIA director. He's close to the president. He shares the president's worldview that North Korea is a dangerous threat to the homeland, that we need a better deal with Iran. And I think he can do an outstanding job explaining to the world President Trump's foreign policy. He's very much in the mainstream as a Republican, someone you would expect a Republican to pick for this job. And he will get confirmed. 15 Democrats voted for him for CIA director. And these are dangerous times, Jake. We're about to enter into negotiations with the North Koreans. And this president, like every other president, deserves to have a qualified cabinet helping them navigate the dangerous times in which we live. So he will be confirmed.
You addressed Gina Haspel's nomination to be CIA director this week, saying that waterboarding was a, quote,
yes,
authorized program at the time, and that if she makes clear that waterboarding is not legal now, that would be enough for you. Your close friend and colleague, Senator John McCain, who obviously survived torture as a prisoner of war in Vietnam, he has said he needs an explanation on her past. What do you say to your good friend about why the Senate should look beyond her story?
Well, I think John is right. I believe that waterboarding was illegal at the time. I helped write the Detainee Treatment Act with Senator McCain, been a military lawyer for over 30 years. But at the time, the Bush administration viewed it as an authorized interrogation technique. After the passage of the Detainee Treatment Act, it is clearly not authorized. And I'm looking for her to acknowledge that this behavior is no longer allowed and that she will adhere to the law as it exists. She, again, is very highly qualified. Mr. Clapper supports her. Leon Panetta supports her. Mr. Hayden supports her. She's excellent at what she does, but she will have to adhere to the law as I believe it exists today, and that will be the test for me.
What about Rand Paul's objection that her name was on the cable ordering the destruction of the videotape evidence of the waterboarding? Does that concern you?
Well, we'll look back and see what she did and what role she played, but I'm looking forward. At that time, the Bush administration, I think, had the wrong view of the law, but the law is now very, very clear, thanks to Senator McCain and others, and I will be looking for her to understand that the law has changed and she cannot engage in these interrogation techniques. I think it undercuts our national security, but in terms of her qualifications, to me, they're second to none.
Attorney General Jeff Sessions fired former FBI Deputy Director Andrew McCabe on Friday night, 2 days before he was set to retire from the agency and receive his pension. McCabe says this was a politically motivated effort driven by the president himself. And though there was this, of course, Inspector General recommendation that he be fired, but President Trump was calling for the firing months ago. He celebrated it on Twitter after it happened. Do you have any concern about the way that President Trump personally has politicized Andrew McCabe?
I think President Trump believes that he's been put upon by the FBI. He reads the texts between the two FBI agents in charge of the Clinton email investigation, showing a bias against him and support for her. And Mr. McCabe, the Office of Professional Responsibility, has recommended that he be dismissed. But to the average American, I think we owe it to the average American to have a hearing in the Judiciary Committee where Mr. Sessions, Attorney General Sessions, comes forward with whatever documentation he has about the firing and give Mr. McCabe a chance to defend himself. I believe when it comes to this issue, we need as much transparency as possible to make sure it wasn't politically motivated.
Take a look at what the president's personal lawyer, John Dowd, told CNN yesterday after McCabe was fired. Quote, speaking for myself, not the president, I pray that Acting Attorney General Rosenstein will follow the brilliant and courageous example of the FBI Office of Professional Responsibility and Attorney General Jeff Sessions and bring an end to alleged Russia collusion investigation manufactured by McCabe's boss, James Comey, based upon a fraudulent and corrupt dossier. Just ended on the merits in light of recent revelations. Obviously, there's a lot to fact check in there that I'm not going to spend the time doing, but a lot of questionable assertions. But since then, the president has tweeted this morning and last night questioning Mueller's team, saying that, quote, the Mueller probe should never have been started. You have said in the past that if President Trump were to order the firing of Special Counsel Mueller, that would, quote, be the end of Trump's presidency. Are you worried or concerned at all that he's preparing to fire Mueller?
Let me be really clear about this. What Mr. McCabe did has absolutely nothing to do with the Mueller investigation. The dossier, I think, was mishandled by the FBI. I think it was inappropriately used and presented to the FISA court. That's a separate issue than the Mueller investigation of the Trump Organization regarding Russia. They're separate in time. They're not connected in any way. The only reason Mr. Mueller could ever be dismissed is for cause. I see no cause when it comes to Mr. Mueller. He needs to be able to do his job independent of any political influence. I pledge to the American people as a Republican to make sure that Mr. Mueller can continue to do his job without any interference. I think he's doing a good job, and everything about McCabe and the FBI handling of the dossier has nothing to do with the Russia investigation regarding Mr. Mueller.
Are you worried that the president is preparing to order the firing of Mueller? It sure looks that way from his tweets.
Well, as I said before, if he tried to do that, that would be the beginning of the end of his presidency, because we're a rule of law nation. What I saw at the FBI and the Department of Justice regarding the dossier really bothered me. It was a paid political document, unverified, used inappropriately by the court. The two FBI agents investigating Clinton had a bias against Trump in favor of Clinton. All that needs to be looked at. That's why I want a separate second special counsel. But when it comes to Mr. Mueller, he is following the evidence where it takes him. And I think it's very important he be allowed to do his job without interference. And there are many Republicans who share my view.
In addition to Russia's recent nerve agent attack in Great Britain, we also learned this week that Russia has targeted American power grids. White House Press Secretary
Yes.
Sarah Sanders on Thursday did not take a stand when asked at a briefing whether Vladimir Putin was a friend or foe. Is Vladimir Putin a friend or foe?
Oh, he's an enemy of democracy. This is why I want Pompeo to be Secretary of State. Mike understands Russia is an enemy of democracy. Mike understands that the North Korean nuclear program can never be allowed to mature to hit the American homeland with a nuclear-tipped ICBM. He understands the Iran nuclear deal is a terrible deal in his current construct. You cannot argue that Mike Pompeo is out of the mainstream when it comes to somebody a Republican president would pick to be Secretary of State. So Mike gets Russia, and I would urge the administration, particularly President Trump, to sanction more people. This first round is good, but their inner circle members around Putin, oligarch types around him, that need to be sanctioned because Russia is on the move throughout the world, and we need to push back more aggressively, and I think Pompeo would do that.
All right, Senator Lindsey Graham, Republican of South Carolina, it's always good to see you, sir. Thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.